Hello, yes. This is RetroTK2 and welcome to this Windows tutorial. Today we're changing the layout of a Mac keyboard on Windows, although the same principles can be applied to any keyboard layout. So let's get started. Fire up Chrome, type Microsoft Keyboard Layout Creator and it should be the second link. Click the download button and when it finishes, click the installer.exe. Click setup, wait for it to unzip and then click next. Click the I agree radio button and keep clicking next. When it finishes installing, click close and open the Keyboard Layout Creator. I like to open the on-screen keyboard as well, yes, since it shows the exact key mappings. If you look at the US version of the Mac keyboard, you'll see it maps to the Windows US keyboard perfectly. It's the UK version that's the problem, yes. You can start from scratch with your keyboard, yes, but I prefer loading a preset. Click File, Load Existing Keyboard, and navigate to the keyboard you'd like to use, yes. You can change the position of the Enter key on the keyboard to match your actual keyboard, yes. The US Mac keyboard uses the first layout, whereas the UK version uses the second. Clicking the Shift checkbox will show the mappings when the Shift key is held. The same goes for Control and the Alt+Ctrl checkboxes. Checking Shift and Control will show the key mappings for when both these keys are held. If you click on a key, a dialog box will pop up. From here you can remap the key to a new one, yes. Simply input the value you want and click OK. Do this for all the mappings you want to change, yes, and use the on-screen keyboard if you're unsure about the current key mappings. Some of the more uncommon characters may not be present on the on-screen keyboard, but you can get these from the net. Type Windows Alt key numeric codes into Google and it should be the first link. Here we get our plus minus key and our section symbol key, but you can map these keys to whatever you like, yes. I like to map the section symbol key to the hash key, since I rarely use the section symbol and I always use the hash key when I'm searching for C# solutions. Once you're happy with your keyboard layout, change the current working directory to the location you want to save your layout, yes. Select File, Save Source File As, and you'll be asked to fill in a few properties for your keyboard layout. Click Yes, give your keyboard a name and description, and click OK. Give the layout a name, select the location for it, and click Save. Now let's install our keyboard layout. To do this, we need to build the setup package. Click Project, Build DLL and Setup Package. Your keyboard may build with some warnings, yes, such as double key bindings. Looking at the log will show you these duplicates, but they're harmless, yes. After the installer builds, head to its directory and click the setup.exe. Your keyboard layout should install successfully, yes. Now we need to select it. Open Control Panel, click Clock, Language and Region, and then click Add a Language. You should see that a new language has been added with our keyboard layout selected. Select the new language and click Move Up. Then select the previous language and click Remove. Now if I open the on-screen keyboard, you'll see it has adopted our new layout, yes. You can change the keyboard layout by clicking Options, then Add an Input Method. Here you can select the keyboard layout you want to use, yes. You can keep both layouts for the same language and switch between them, but I prefer keeping the one layout per language. Click Save to confirm the changes, yes. You can uninstall your keyboard layout like a standard program. Open Control Panel and click Uninstall a Program. Navigate to your layout and click it to uninstall. You may hit an error if the layout is currently in use, but that's easily solved by selecting a different keyboard layout. Having the right keyboard layout will greatly increase your workflow, yes. And that's it. Rate, comment and subscribe, yes. Feel free to get in touch. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with other productivity suggestions. Thank you for watching, yes, and I'll see you in the next video.